save some wood from the fire.
It brings me great comfort to know that Nicholas is
the ash.
Very well, I'll take a look at it.
I hope you will give me word if you find anything about my brother.
I welcome you, friend of the Skull.
It is the will of the All-Maker. That fire would only become the dead thing.
I came here to study the history of Sosa.
It's been many winters since my husband returned to the army. But my heart still aches from him.
The All-Maker protect us from whatever dark power took control of the Skull. Oh, my mother used to say that I was born an angry child. It's true that my heart has always been restless, and fighting was the only way I could find peace. I was a soldier for a time, and then a mercenary, but I was never truly happy until I came here. Well, the dragons are a constant danger, but so far they have taken little interest in our village. Thank the All-Maker for that. They forced us to change the way we live our lives? No, not at all. They are but one more hardship added to the many we already endure. Until next time. You freed us from the dark moon. That is Skull our grief.
I do enjoy sharing the stories of my travels in Tamerial with young Nicholas. Take care.
Every winter. Gash, when the angry mountains creep closer.
It brings me great comfort to know that Nicholas is here. I thank you.
I am called Wolf Wildblood. I am first hunter of the Skull. He never felt the call of the All-Maker as I do, as we all should. We seek to live in peace with the land, but he had an eye for dominance and strength, for unnatural strength. You need look no further than the beasts of this island, mangled by the Daedra. It's not a fate I would wish on anyone, and not what I wanted for my brother. May your hunts all... Spring you gain. I hope you will give me word if you find anything about my brother. We seek to live in peace with the land, but he had an eye for dominance and strength. I know a warrior when I see one, friend of the Skull. Deer, bear, and horker provide most of what we need for skins and meat. Sometimes, when the wolves grow too bold and threaten the village, we must hunt them to cull their numbers.
Good day.
It brings me great comfort to know that you.
I welcome you, friend of the Skull.
I'm a prisoner. Outsider. I remember you. You're the one who freed the skull from the dark spell.
Thank the All-Maker that you have come. These accursed elves have taken me from my home.
No. No, my wounds are not serious. I don't think the elves were trying to harm me. Perhaps they intended to frighten me. At worst, I have a few bruises to show for my ordeal. I do not know this word, Thalmor. But if you mean the elves, they were trying to learn the secrets of forging stalwart. Their leader, an elf named Ankarian, has a map. He says that it shows the location of a hidden source of stalwart.
Enchanted ice. As hard as iron and as cold as death. Stalrum can be forged into deadly weapons, but the art is known only to the smiths of the skull.
They have a ship. They took me there and showed me the map. You will find it on the northern coast of the island. Please. Do not let Ankarian make his weapons. Kill him or let him live. But take the map from him. It belongs with the skull. I will return to the village. When you have the map, please bring it to me there. And thank you. May the All-Maker bless your days. You will find the elf ship at anchor along the northern coast of the island. The one named Ankarian.
Something. You are trespassing here. I strongly suggest you move along. Thalmor to arms! Kill the intruder!
Pikachu, use Thunderbolt!
Come on.
Let's give it our all!
It's so good to see you again.
It is good to see you again, my friend. Did you find the elves at their ship? I know you faced great danger to bring this map to me. There are no words to tell how glad my heart is. Thank you, brave one. I name you Friend of the Skull, and I will trust you with the knowledge of forging the Stalrim. If you bring Stalrim here to my forge, you can use my tools to make what you will from it. Until our next meeting, Skull friend. May your hunts always bring you game, and your crops grow tall and bountiful.
Thank you.
I heard from Dior how you went in search of Baldur. That was very brave. And in fact, that's just the kind of courage I'm looking for. Quite right, quite right. This, however, is paying work. Allow me to explain. As a scholar of history, I've always found Solstheim to be most intriguing. I've made many forays into the ancient ruins that cover the island. I've come to know those ruins so well, I could draw you a map from memory. That's why I noticed the new passage the moment I laid eyes on it. An old tomb, I think. It must have been opened by an earthquake that accompanied one of the Red Mountain's eruptions. I'd love to have a closer look. Those old ruins can be dangerous. I'm no adventurer. I'll pay you to watch my back down there. I'll be heading back there soon. If you're interested, meet me at the ruins and we'll see what we can find. Now I'm off to pack for the expedition. Remarkable, isn't it? This tomb has been hidden for... Well, who knows? Remarkable, isn't it? This tomb has been hidden for... Well, who knows how long? Many centuries, I would think. I've had a look around, and the only interesting thing I've found is this inscription here, and a switch below. Now, I'm not sure if you can read the dragon language, but this seems to be a riddle of some sort. A sacrifice will bring you closer to that which you seek. I wonder what it means. Mind your step. There seem to be some corpses strewn.
Watch over your back, friend.
This tomb is remarkably well preserved. Fortune has truly smiled on us.
What are you doing that for?
Something?
This place was a remarkable find.
What are you doing that for?
Pikachu, let's do it!
By their own means. Sounds like a grim if you ask me. The inscription must be a reference to these pillars.
Hey, watch him!
Now let's see what mysteries await us in the next room.
Pikachu, let's give it our all!
Pikachu!
There's probably an entrance through one of these sarcophagi. Let's get moving. Walking in these chambers is like walking in the past. Let's be extra careful.
Thank you.
is another riddle. Stay your course, to idle is to die. Well, at least it's straightforward. There appears to be a switch of some kind here. I'll just stand over here while you flip that switch. I'm sure everything will be fine. How remarkable to think these passages have gone undisturbed for so long. Exciting, wouldn't you agree? Who knows what dangers await us in this place? the Hall of Stories. These are found in many ancient Nord tombs. There must be hundreds of years of history etched in these walls. Too bad they seem too damaged to read. Looks like it needs some sort of key. Maybe those half-claws you found would fit in here if you put them together. It seems these rings can be moved. Perhaps there's enough undamaged text in these etchings to tell us the combination. Ah, yes. Here's something. The first one has to do with a breeze. Or maybe it's wind. The second one mentions the night sky and the moon. And the third has something to do with fire. It also seems to mention scales. That's all I can make out from this etching. I'll check the rest and see if there's anything else. You keep trying out the combinations. Let's be extra careful.
Pikachu, let's do it!
Just let me study these runes for a moment. Here's another mention of a guardian. I only assume that this is the guardian's tomb we're standing in now. It says that he was loyal, and his reward was an honorable death. Quite fascinating. How amazing! A real dragon priest! In all my years as a historian, I never thought I'd see anything like that. I suppose that was Valak. He must have had this entire place built for him so that he could maintain his vigil, even beyond death. Indeed. I knew that the dragon priests were thought to have been powerful men of great will. I had no idea. Well, I suppose I've seen everything I came for, and you kept up your end of the bargain. I promised payment, and here it is. Now I think I'll spend some more time studying this word war. What a book this will make! History truly comes alive here, don't you think? This is clearly a tomb, if a rather elaborate one. I would guess it was built for a dragon priest who achieved great fame in his time. It seems he was held in high regard by both men and dragons, because he defeated a traitor named Mirak. Perhaps Mirak was also a dragon priest, probably a contemporary of this guardian. He must have turned against his own order. After his defeat, Mirak was banished to Solstheim, and the guardian was made his jailer. I've been thinking about that, and I believe it does. I believe it was the ancient ancestors of the Skull who built this tomb for their master, a dragon priest they called the Guardian. In all likelihood, these people were ancient Nords who came with the dragon priest to live here on Solstheim. Separated from their people on the mainland, they developed a distinct culture that became the Skull we know today. Of course, this is all just theory and conjecture. It is likely we will never know the truth. A good question. Partly to keep unwanted intruders away, I suppose. They might also have been meant as tests, to ensure that only the truly worthy can reach the main burial chamber. Who can say, really? The motives of the dragon priests are as inscrutable as those of the dragons they worship. Return to my studies.
Pikachu, let's give it our all!
Pikachu! What do you want? That's freaking amazing! Let's roll!
Like to advance the art of magic?
I suppose that depends. Are you willing to be an experimental subject? Oh, nothing too dangerous. It should provide an additional spectral tether from your own life spark to the Adric realm. You would experience it as a sort of increased vigor. You would fight longer, feel stronger, that sort. At least I think it will. Probably. Almost certainly. Of course, you never can tell. Now stand still. It's my first time casting this spell, and I don't need any additional distractions. You won't feel a thing, but if you do, try not to scream too loudly. My ears are sensitive. Off you go. If you discover any side effects, come back and tell me straight away. Are we done? I thought so. Where is that lazy steward of mine? Verona? Oh no, wait, she's dead. Drovers! Wet, you say? I suppose, yes, I can see how that would have inverted the tether. Unfortunate. Couldn't you simply avoid water? No, that won't do. Can't have you forego bathing. The Ashlands can leave one a bit pungent, and it's, obvious you've been through them. Here, I'll just remove it. Here's a bit of coin. Should help mitigate your inconvenience. That's that, then.
So the dragons have returned. Well, the Skull have survived worse. Hermes Mora. Old Hermamora himself. So he is the source of Irak's power. Of course. We have many tales of Hermamora trying to trick us into giving up our secrets to him. And now he comes again for what we have long kept from him. Ancient lore, handed down from shaman to shaman since the All-Maker first gave Solstheim to the Skull. How to talk to the wind, how to listen to the earth. These are our secrets. Nothing of power or mastery. We know him as Hermamora, the demon of knowledge. It is in his nature to hoard secrets to himself. Their value to him is of no consequence. The very fact that the Skull have kept knowledge from him has merely increased his desire. So it falls to me to be the one to give up the secrets to our ancient enemy. I do not know if I have the strength to face him. The Tree Stone is still corrupted. The land is still out of balance. But with the other five restored, it may be enough. It will have to be. Yes. The Skull also tell of the day when we must finally give up our secrets. When Hermamora finally wins. As shaman, it is my duty to guard these secrets, but also to decide when it is necessary to give them up. I believe that time is now. If I am wrong, will my ancestors forgive me? Give me the book. I will read it and speak to old Hermamora myself. I will make sure he lives up to his part of the bargain. That is my hope as well. I am trusting that you will make this sacrifice worthwhile.
Father, you must not do this. That book is wrong, evil, against everything you have taught me my whole life.
I must, friend. It is the only way to free Solstheim forever from Irak's shadow. There comes a time when everything must change. Nothing that lives remains the same. Do not fear for me, my daughter. This is the destiny that the old Maker has laid out for me.
I stand beside you, Father. As always.
Huh? I am ready for whatever the foul master of this book has in store for me.
The Skull yield up their secrets to me. I give you the word of power that you need to challenge Mirak. You will be either a worthy opponent or his successor, as the tides are faded.
Father! What have you done? Father sacrificed himself so you could destroy Mirak and lift his master's shadow from the land. Go then, kill Mirak. Do not fail.
Freya will grieve, but she will prove a good shaman. Stone taught her well. He knew she was ready to guide us in his place.
Sarota, are you so easily swayed? No, not yet. We should greet our guest first. And so the first Dragonborn meets the last Dragonborn at the summit of Apocrypha. No doubt, just as Hermaeus Mora intended, he is a fickle master, you know. But now I will be free of him. My time in Apocrypha is... You are here in your full power, and thus subject to my full power. You will die, and with the power of your soul, I will return to Solstheim and be master of my own fate once again. Cruising well. So that I can be a
Belly.
wanted to use me to deal with Aldiun. I chose otherwise. I know things.
Little thief who escaped me, Mirat. You can hide nothing from me here. No matter. I have found a new dragonborn to serve me.
May she be rewarded for her service as I am.
Mira,
harbored fantasies of rebellion against me. Serve me faithfully, and you will continue to be richly rewarded.
Have you heard the tale of Matthew Bellamont and the great treachery of Jaden Hall? Killboy's mother and vengeance festers in the sun.
I can feel it. The tree stone is free again. The oneness of the land is restored. Does that mean... is it over? Is Mirak defeated? Thank you. Whatever your other reasons for acting, you have done the Skull a great service. We will not forget what you have done. One more thing, Skullfer. If you will. I know it is not my place, but... may I offer a word of advice? Of warning? As Shaman of the Skull, I am charged with the spiritual well-being of my people. While you are not of the Skull, you are Skull friend. And so I give you this warning. Hermamora forced you to serve him in order to defeat Mirak. Do not let him lure you further down the path. The All-Maker made you Dragonborn for a higher purpose. Do not forget that. Walk with the All-Maker, Skullfriend.
Talk to Captain Gowland if you're looking to book passage.
Let's get going. What do you need to take? Lead on, then.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see here. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Passage. Talk to Captain Gallen.
Captain Gallen does the business around here. I'm just a ship's mate.
The warm sand of elsewhere is far away from here. May your road lead you to warm sands.
Huh? A peaceful greeting to you.
I welcome you, friend. How may I serve you? He hired the others and paid for my goods. I am allowed to run the caravan, but I pay Grisad a percentage of my profits. I say this without bitterness, for it was Grisad who saved me from a life of servitude aboard a trading ship. I am grateful to have the life that I do now. It is a far cry from my days as an orphan on the streets of Corinth. Quite the opposite, in fact. The soldiers are some of our best customers, for we offer supplies and wares they cannot obtain by other means. It was Resad's idea to come here now, while the land is in turmoil. Where others saw only danger, he saw opportunity.
I hope that you will come to do business with us again.
Thank you.
taste it.
He knows that. They all know that.
How long are you going to wait? If by message you mean shoving a sword through his gullet,
take it. City are leaving him in this place in a more powerful state.
So we're ready to start this war in earnest then.
Soon.
I still say you should put it all out like you did before it. I still say you won't.
Whoever we replace them with will need a sword.
Talos guide you. It's him next time. Fight or die well. Need something? Respect my life, sir. Don't plan to stop now. Rather, what the empire. I'm not much of a strategist. Lord Ulfric listens to my counsel all the same.
What prey awaits us?
What?
I think they'd show them more respect than me. Will do.
The way I see it, Ulfric's fighting a holy war.
A speaker for the Black Hand. But you have been made listener.
That it?
We going? Lead the way.
Telling me, Ulfric's planning an attack on White.
Be insane to try. He doesn't have the men.
Scouts report, sir. Every day more join the cause. Riften, Dawnstar, and Winterhold support him.
It's not the cause.
Call it whatever you like, General. The man's going to try to take my life.
Keep your guard up.
Taste it.
All group refuses to be instructed. Harrison troops in a city. On the other hand, Ulfric.
What a waste.
I'm going to find whoever did this.
My blade is yours.
like to forget that the Empire's what's keeping the Dominion out of Skyrim.
Perhaps we should find a random stranger to murder. This does
me. Yes?
By the gods, the Emperor's been murdered on his own ship.
We going?
Lead the way.
In life, I was but a speaker for the Black Hand. But you have
you hear that? I swear there's something out there.
Melaron, you lazy milk drinker. Imports from Black Marsh.
Damn, Sean.
So exciting when new folk come into town. I bet you've had plenty of adventures.
Powers of the void.
Someone do something!
Mercy!
Thane Bryling, at your service.
Someday, I'll be a gallant heroine. You make it look so...
What say you in your defense?
I remember Skyrim from my youth,
and I'm also aware.
And the glistening crimson.
Smart woman. Now come along with us. We'll take any stolen goods and you'll be free to go. After you pay the fine, of course.
Fine day with you around. If you have business, please see Falk Firebeard, my steward. With the passing of my dear husband, Torig, the weighty position of Jarl has fallen to me. Please direct questions to my steward. Be well.
Lead the way.
These are quite expensive. I trust you know how limited the whole funds are.
Matthew Bellamont and
yes,
the great
and I'm also aware of how necessary my donations and units have been in the city. My experiments are all I ask for in return.
Very well, but I suspect her grace will not be pleased.
And? I've seen Jarls come and go. This one only became Jarl because her husband died. She'll be replaced in a matter of months.
Please address all questions to my Folk Fireblade. Please address all questions. Stuart, Folk Fireblade.
Now give it. My work awaits.
Ah, yes. Solitude. Seat of the High King of Skyrim.
It's so good to see you.
Messy business. Please address all questions to the steward. For fire. Be satisfied.
Your tongue, wizard, or your life.
Please address all questions to the steward.
It's a fine day with you around. Stop it, both of you. You're acting like children. Oh.
stop.
What is it?
Our cat. Here, this is fresh. I'll have another one late tomorrow.
Fiddling with any locks around here, we're going to have a real problem.
What prey awaits us? There is murder in the air. I can taste it.
What is it?
Keep your guard up.
If you need potions, head over to Angeline's Aromatics.
I spent my life serving towers. I don't plan to stop now.
I was this close to catching that killer, I swear it.
As does my blade.
Huh?